my name is Ida Torre. I'm a senior at Blackstone Academy, and I'm going to be graduating this year.
My name is Jayshawn. I am a rising senior. I live in Providence.
Hi, my name is Promise Early. I'm 17. I'm currently a senior.
My name is AD, or Anthony, but I go by AD. I'm in 10th grade.
Actually, I'm 11th grade.
Okay. Oh, I be forgetting. I'm in 11th grade now. You know Corona, so I forget. But yeah, I'm in 11th grade, junior now.
Hi, my name is Deanna Lees. My nickname is Dee. I'm Dominican. As you can see, kind of look, you know, white, but I'm not. I am black.
Hello, my name is Bianca. I am from Providence, also from Tanzania, which is where I was born.
So my name is Ava. I'm a senior at Blackstone Academy. I'm 17 years old from Providence.
My name is Renz, well, short for Lorenz, apparently. I live in Central Falls.
Hi, my name is Nisi. I am 17 and I'm from Pawtucket.
When I first got the email from V, I was really excited because I was in my room thinking about what can I do to help out. And when I got this email, I was like, oh my God, this is the perfect spot for me to tell other students about the situations that I've been through, to tell other students about, to like let them know that it's okay to speak up and to let people know how you feel.
My first reaction to there being an all-black group, it was like cool. But when I first thought about it, I just thought about like George Floyd and like talking about police brutality and just being able to get together with people that I know that go to the same school as me and just talking about it. You're talking to like people that are young, that are growing up and gonna experience the world just like you are. So it's like, it's cool.
When I first saw the email that invited me to here, I felt honored because it was just like, we're preaching you love and power. And I'm like, yes, I love that. Yes, I'm here for it.
What I thought was like, I actually have a chance to actually do something and make it happen. I have a chance to get my voice out there and let it be heard.
I think the first thing that went through my mind about the BLI was like, oh, this is just end result to what's going on in the world. And then I like actually thought about it and I thought it's gonna be fun and interesting because there's people that look like me and that come from similar backgrounds and have similar experiences.
I was like, oh my gosh, really? Like, I was like so excited.
I have a lot to say about, you know, the black community and why we are important.
It's an opportunity for me to make a change for my black community and like inspire other people to be involved and make changes.
I wanted to join BLI because I wanted to show that we have a voice and we can't stay silent.
I felt stuck in my house and I wanted to do something.
I wanted to join BLI because I really want to contribute to my own community, especially after the obstacles I faced throughout this year and the circumstances that we're in right now as a like country.
I wanted to be a part of BLI because I feel like I could be a role model to my community.
I just always had a passion for the black community, the black culture, because I'm black. And I wanna be proud and I wanna know how to talk to people about our issues without offending them or without making them feel like they're less than. I've been feeling outraged because, I mean, it's always been going on. Like, people just haven't been recording it. There was no social media back in the day.
Since the beginning of the country, like since the early stages of the colonization, we as in black people, like systematically, we've always been at the bottom.
But other people outside of the black community are seeing for themselves. Mm-hmm. And they can't discredit what someone says, what they saw.
The fact that we have to debate whether or not Black Lives Matter or Black Lives Matter 2, the specific statements about whether or not Black Lives Matter, like it is what it is. And it's really just, it's just disappointing.
I've been feeling so scared because I'm scared that one day anything could happen to me when I walk out in public. I don't feel safe walking out because someone can look at my skin color as a threat and I'm no threat to nobody.
People need to understand that everyone's human and everyone are entitled to like their life. Like they shouldn't have to worry about their life being taken away. And it hurts me to see like a lot of people going through pain when people back then have gone through a lot of enough pain. Like we shouldn't be going through this still.
Being a black male affects my life because I feel like they find like us more threats and they feel some of us like coming from like certain places, they see us as like bad people or like we're all the same.
Why is it like this in 2020? We fight for equality and we're not gonna stop. It's not a trend and it's not gonna stop. It's gonna keep on going until we actually get equality.
I want everyone to get together, like, and be united. Young girls that are insecure about their skin color, and I feel like your skin color is beautiful regardless of how black you are, how light you are, you're beautiful regardless.
I want them to know that they're loved. I know a lot of black kids think, like, since they're black and, like, a lot of things happen because of we're black, like maybe bullying or discrimination or a lot of things that happen in school, it's like they're loved and they're powerful and they, like, they're the same as everyone else.
The change that needs to happen is you gotta, like, come together as a community first, start letting your voice be heard, because our voices need to be heard to make a change.
I want life to be like how it feels like in my school. I want everyone to feel comfortable when they step out their house. I want people to feel like they're loved.
Well, I'm hoping to make a change. That's like the one big thing I want. My service learning project was to bring in HBCUs, which is historically black colleges and universities, to bring them up here because we don't have any HBCUs around us except for, like, in Delaware, but that's still kind of far. I saw that there was a lack of promotion of black colleges in the school, so I thought it would be eye-opening to other people that there's more than one option.
Peace. I want everybody to know that we're all equal and we both bleed the same blood.
I really want to shine a light on inner city kids having more opportunities. I came to this country when I was about to start kindergarten. I couldn't speak good English, so they told me that I had to stay back a year, and I felt targeted. My parents would be called, like, all the time to come and pick me up because of little things, like my hair wasn't right. My mom and my dad saved up for months and months, and when I came to Providence, I was, like, really excited to be around kids like me.
My first session at BLI, it was so fun. We were playing these icebreaker games. It was kind of hard for everyone to catch on. But once we got into the rhythm, at least most of us, it was, like, it was comfortable. And when we were sharing our, like, feelings and, like, explaining why we feel that way, I've never seen that before. Like, people just ask me, how do you feel? Not, why do you feel that way?
I was a little bit nervous, you know, but it was amazing, obviously, because of the people that are here.
I don't feel like I have to hide something because most of those kids know what I'm talking about. They understand. They've been through it. And I don't feel I have to sugarcoat anything.
What stuck out to me was how important it was to people. Because, to be honest, I didn't think, like, a lot of people were going to talk or it wasn't, like, really mattered. People really was moved by what other people were saying. This first, like, meeting, it went by quick too. I thought 2 hours was gonna last a long time, but it wasn't even enough time. We overpassed it. So I feel like it was a really good meeting today, and I can't wait for the next one.
I've never experienced something like this. I've never been in a group where it's only my people making changes for the community. And this is, like, a really, really, really good opportunity for me and for my brothers and sisters to make changes in this community.
This space is very special to me because, you know, at least in the Blackstone community, we, like, make a joke about the only 20 black kids in this school. And this one program that just gathers all of us up just to talk about being black kind of, like, made me laugh, honestly. I really don't see that.
When I'm in a room full of white people, I feel uncomfortable in a way because I don't want to say anything or do anything that makes them upset or uncomfortable like I am. And to know that there's a space where I don't have to feel that kind of makes me happy and hopeful for the future.
Power, strength, and just being brave.
Being black is being proud and fighting, and fight for the people who fought before you, for you to have to be equal. Our power.
I love BLI. I'm sorry to love this. I can't wait, y'all guys. Thank you.